There are 5 million people in Singapore. They come from various parts of the world that carry different languages.
I'm from Indonesia. I'm from South Korea.
I'm from Pakistan.
And I'm from Canada.
Even the Singaporeans themselves are already made up of 4 different major ethnicities and therefore speak their own languages. The Singaporean Chinese alone speak 4 different dialects, which are Mandarin, Hokkien, Teochew, and Guangdong. Not to forget languages like Tamil, Hindi, Malay, and the first language of Singapore, the English language. However, these differences are united by one language that is unique to Singapore, the Singlish or Singaporean English.
I think Singlish is some Chinese mixed and English is together, used together.
Singlish is a mix of English and a Singaporean dialect, which is a mix also of ethnic lines, Malay, Cantonese, Hokkien, a bit of Tamil also.
Singlish, I think it's like making English in a shorter form.
So it's a blend of English which is spoken in Singapore, but that is not really accurately correct.
Well, examples of Singlish often come from Chinese backgrounds more than any other, of course, just like the population. Singapore is made up of a majority of Chinese, so the most of Singlish, you can see that it comes from a lot of Chinese speaking, a lot of endings from Chinese.
Let's say you want to say, can you please confirm what you are saying? In Singlish, you can just say, confirm not.
The obvious thing you can say is la.
Or,
cannot make it la, CMI, cannot make it. It's something like, below standard or, something that you can't actually fulfill the requirements.
Of course. Language influences any culture, right? But there's also things that influence the language.
It's sort of a laid-back culture. If you are talking Singlish, that means you can afford to be informal with someone. Let's say you go to the hawker center and then you don't talk proper English to that guy. I mean, he wouldn't understand. So in a sense, if you talk Singlish, you are expected to be a bit relaxed.
I'd say that the Singaporean culture influences English.
But Singaporeans are Malay, Chinese, Tamil speaking, and our cultures are influenced by our own languages. Mm-hmm. It doesn't have to be Singlish.
Okay. For Singaporean, it's useful. But like me, it's not so useful.
Actually, I'm okay with Singlish, but I meet people around, like foreigners. They don't really like Singlish that much because they think like it's not proper English.
I think it's perfectly fine and it's perfectly natural because most people here are Chinese, and so as long as a group of people can understand what they're trying to say, as long as they communicate. The problem comes when you're trying to communicate with other English speakers.
If one can code switch, it is okay. But many people in Singapore can't code switch. They can't tell the difference between Singlish and English. So it's really important that they know what English is, what standard English is, before they even consider speaking Singlish.
I think I'm very proud of Singlish. It's our cultural identity. Without Singlish, you wouldn't know that someone is a Singaporean. So, I mean, there's a hullabaloo about the, guys going about saying we shouldn't speak English, because it's not professional, it's not in the business language. But the thing is, without Singlish, we don't have any identity at all.
Singlish is often deemed rude by foreigners, but by those who know it and experience it, it is a language that brings them closer together. It is also representing a culture that is friendly and concise.